Hello there, everyone, and welcome to the Weekend Love Readings with me, Miss Machiste. We are going to be looking at every sign in this video. Please keep in mind, this is the Weekend Love Reading for the weekend of November 6th, 7th, and 8th. Time is fluid. Everyone has their own divine timing and their own divine order from spirit. So please, please keep that in mind as we navigate through these readings. Also, a special shout out to all of my subscribers. Thank you for all of your likes, your shares, your subscribes. It really helps my channel grow and it really helps me connect with more beautiful, wonderful souls like yours. Also, a very special shout out to about 15 or 20 of you that have emailed me and DM'd me on Instagram about how much you enjoy the Weekend Love Readings, that I ended up taking the spread that I do in the Weekend Love Readings, putting it into the monthlies for the November monthly readings, and they ended up doing so well. So thank you, thank you, thank you to all of those people who have suggested that to me within the last week or so, maybe about like 2 weeks. I've been getting emails like that, and I'm so glad that you guys like the you versus them reading and spread. I enjoy it as well. So I did put that in the November love readings. So if you are looking for a more in-depth you versus them spread, you can go check out the November love readings. All signs are released. It's in the November 2020 playlist. We're going to be doing the you versus them spread in this reading. So you will be on this side. They will be on this side. The mutual energy will be down the middle. Please keep in mind that for some of you, this reading may resonate backwards. You may end up on their side. They may end up on your side. So please keep that in mind. For some of you, it will resonate reversed, backwards, flipped. Whatever word you want to use, that may happen for some of you. The energy will not come out perfectly all the times. There are thousands and thousands of you watching. So keep that in mind. Assign the roles as you wish and take what resonates, leave what doesn't. Also, please keep in mind to check out your sun, moon, rising, and Venus sign. Not all messages will resonate with everyone out there. So please check out your other sign placements as well. In the description box below, you will find the timestamps for this video. So if you do not wish to watch this whole video, you can click on the timestamp of the sign you wish to watch. YouTube will jump you to that point in the video. We're going to be doing the you versus them mutual spread. These are quick spreads. Keep in mind, this is the weekend love reading, okay? So if you're looking for something in depth, you know where to go. And I didn't get out any dailies this week. I know I was very booked, but I am going to do a moonology card at the end of each reading to get some specific guidance from the universe. And, you know, we have a lot of moon things happening. We have the Gemini moon at the end of the month, which is an eclipse. So definitely keep that in mind as we navigate the rest of the couple months, because there is going to be a lot of moon energy. The moon, it will shift our lives. The moon has a lot to do with the way things go in our lives. So keep that in mind. Just remember, you know, the moon, like, look what it does to the ocean. Look what the moon does to the ocean. And what are we? We're 70-something% water. And you don't think we're going to be phased by the moon? So I'm done talking. Okay, here we go. So let's get into it. We are going to be doing the you versus them spread. We're going to start with my water signs because it's Scorpio season. So we're going to start with my Scorpios. I normally start with Cancer, but I'm going to start with Scorpio. Hopefully I don't mess up and start saying Cancer, but I don't like when I change the order, but we're going to start with Scorpio. Something's telling me to start with Scorpio, so we're going to start with Scorpio. So, hello, hello to my beautiful, wonderful, beautiful Scorpios. Happy birthday to all my Scorpios out there. Sending you a lot of love, a lot of light, a lot of peace, and a lot of blessings. Scorpio, please stay safe out there celebrating your birthday. Things are going down around here. Things are just very all over the place, honestly. But that's what would happen, you know? We're moving into a new age, so we have to rid of the things we used to be doing. The things that used to be normal to us are not going to be normal to us anymore. The age of Aquarius is coming. So let's get into it for Scorpio. How are my Scorpios feeling, Spirit, this weekend in their love lives? Please show me Scorpio's energy for this weekend in their love lives. What is going on with my Scorpios? Okay, Scorpio. Your energy is strength. Okay. The Empress and the Chariot. Beautiful. All major arcanas could be dealing with a Cancer, a Taurus, or a Libra with that Empress. Or strength with the could be dealing with a Leo. I see you moving forward, Scorpio. I see you regaining your strength, regaining your willpower. You know, you may be holding back a little bit from love, but you are really trying to get your strength up. I feel like you are sitting in your power right now. You know who you are. You know what you got to offer. Other people are seeing you for this true Empress energy as well. They see you for valuable, abundant Scorpio that you are. And I feel like you're moving forward. You may actually maybe moving residency with the Chariot, or you're traveling this weekend. You may be going out this weekend with the Chariot here. Definitely you're going to go, if you're going out, ooh, you're going to look real good, Scorpio. So if you're going out for your birthday, definitely going to have all eyes on you. So let's see what this person you're connecting with this weekend is up to. Spirit, who is Scorpio connecting with this weekend? Who are my Scorpios connecting with? Okay, Scorpio, your person is coming through as the Three of Pentacles. The Eight of Pentacles. And the Five of Pentacles. Ooh, okay, so Scorpio, the person you're dealing with, the first thing I heard was that they may have just lost their job. Or they want to work together with you. They want to put effort and energy into this connection. But I don't know how big of a chance you're giving them, because they feel neglected from you with the Five of Pentacles. So this person, they either lost their job or they're feeling very financially down. And you're like shining. So they may be feeling a bit intimidated here. Or maybe that they're not good enough for you right now. But we have the Three of Pentacles. You may have worked with this person. But I'm really feeling that something is going on at their job. Or something has been going on with their finances here. They want to put work into you. They want to put effort into this connection with the Eight of Pentacles. But I also feel like something happened with them on their end, where they may be like really trying to find new work, or trying to find new jobs, or trying to level up at work, or something along the lines. I feel like somebody's very focused on their money right now. And I almost feel like they don't feel good enough for you. So let's see the mutual energy between you and this person, Scorpio. You may have abandoned them, Scorpio. You may have, if this is not them losing their job, they feel very left out from this connection. So, Spirit, can I please have the mutual energy between Scorpio and the person they're dealing with this weekend? Okay, we have the Knight of Pentacles. We have the Hierophant. And we have the Star. Oh, beautiful. Okay, so a lot of major arcanas coming through. And I feel a lot of earth energy. So definitely could be dealing with a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Very strongly a Taurus. You know, I feel like Scorpio, this person, they see you for the beautiful, abundant, valuable person that you are. And I feel like they're intimidated by you. I really feel like they look at you as higher up than they are. And I feel like something is going on in their end with their finances, where I feel like they may feel like they can't support you, or that they need more to support this connection, or you know, maybe they want to take you out for your birthday, maybe they're trying to get you a birthday present or something like that, and they feel like they can't match maybe people in your life that are going to spend a lot of money on you or something. But this person wants to work on this with the Hierophant in the middle. I feel like, Scorpio, I'm really feeling if you didn't neglect this person, then this person is very intimidated by your growth and by your abundance. And they want wish fulfillment with you. You want wish fulfillment with them. So if you have Scorpio, you know if you abandoned this person. You know. I honestly feel like a lot of you Scorpios didn't. I just feel like there's some sort of finance issue on their side. This is going to be something that has potential to be in a committed relationship, or you are already committed in this relationship and money is slow or something. I feel very strong finance situation. But we do have the Star, so there will be hope and healing for this connection. There will be wish fulfillment. This is Aquarius energy. Could be dealing with an Aquarius, but things are going to be okay with your finances in this connection. So if you're married to this person and things are just going south with their finances, things are going to be okay. Very interesting, Scorpio. I really feel very strongly for a lot of you Scorpios who are just dating somebody or just dating around or something. There's one person who wants to put so much work and effort into this connection, and I feel like you want the same, but I don't know. They don't feel very confident in themselves. Scorpio, I feel like they're looking at you like you are like the best thing since sliced bread, and they're feeling so intimidated, but I do feel like they are going to be wanting to heal with you. They're going to be wanting, they want to have hope for this connection. So let's get some message from the universe through the Moonology deck for Scorpio. There is going to be hope, Scorpio. So whatever financial issue or whatever issue that you're having with this person where it's either feeling left out or feeling some sort of financially burdened, things are going to get better. Things are going to look up. So, let's get a Moonology for Scorpio. I definitely feel like, Scorpio, you may be going out or something like that for your birthday or traveling for your birthday. And maybe this person is, like, feeling some type of way about it. Let's see. We have, you and your loved ones are safe. New Moon in Cancer. And we're going to get one more. I love that. I always say that. I'm always like, I love that card. But we want more, you know? But we always love knowing that you and your loved ones are safe, for sure. And that's definitely a very good sign for my people who are in a commitment or in a marriage where money is not great right now. So let's get one more card. All right, we have a fiery climax approaches, full moon in Aries. Yeah, this is the need to conclude a extremely hard time as well, but with a fiery climax approaches as well, full moon in Aries, that's showing that there is going to be something that is going to change. Something is going to peak. Something is going to come to its climax, and then things will start to fall into place. So I definitely feel like, Scorpio, something's going on this weekend. I feel like you're feeling great. I just feel like the person that you're dealing with is either intimidated by your growth or something happened with them and their finances, something along those lines. You want to heal with them. You want to find hope with them. You want this to work. And so do they. So that's what I got for you, Scorpio. Thank you for being here. Thank you for watching. And I'll see y'all very, very soon. Okay. To my Cancers. Hello to my Cancers, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs. For my Cancers spirit, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, how are my Cancers feeling this weekend? For November 6th to November 6th, 7th, and 8th, there you go. So spirit, how are my Cancers doing? Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs for my Cancers. what's going on for my Cancers, how are my Cancers doing to this weekend in their love lives. All right, Cancer, let's see. Ooh, that cup fell. That is meant to be. Okay. Here we go, Cancer. We have the Five of Pentacles. We have Temperance. And we have the Page of Swords. Okay, so Cancer, you may be feeling neglected, abandoned with this Five of Pentacles. You may have been ghosted as well in your love life. Possibly somebody left you out in the cold, or you've been feeling extremely, extremely neglected from this connection. But you do have somebody with you, and that's Spirit. So don't forget to turn around and acknowledge them, because they're here helping you through this moment. We also have Temperance, Sagittarius energy. So there's something happening for you behind the scenes. Spirit is saying to be patient with Temperance. I feel like you have your eye on somebody, Cancer. You may be watching somebody from afar here with the Page of Swords. Somebody may be watching you. I feel like, well, it's on your side. So I definitely feel like, Cancer, you have your eye on somebody. Or I feel like you're trying to figure out something. You may be trying to figure out why this happened. You may be trying to figure out why you feel this way. You may be trying to figure out why this person left you in the cold, or why this person is neglecting this connection. I do feel like you're going to figure it out within due time with Temperance there. You know, everyone hates the word patience, but that's what Temperance screams, patience. But, you know, patience is interesting. You know, if you're into manifestations, I'm getting my manifestation series out, and here's a little key for you. Your attitude while being patient is more, has more power over you being patient. So if your attitude is putting pressure on what you're waiting for, it's going to put pressure back onto you and not happen as fast as you thought it would. So release the pressure, because I feel like some of you Cancers, you have your eye on, you're trying to figure it out. You're trying to figure something out. So let's get your person's energy here. You're really trying to figure out why this is happening. And as you should, you know, we're all curious of things. It's a human nature to be curious about things. So let's see, Spirit, can you please give us, who is Cancer connecting to? Could be a earth sign, a air sign, or a Sagittarius. Who is Cancer connecting with? Okay, Cancer, we have the Four of Pentacles. Okay, we have the Six of Pentacles. And we have the Knight of Wands. Okay, so it looks to me, Cancer, like you're dealing with somebody who's in and out, back and forth. I feel like this reminds me of your November love reading. So if you want to go check that out, go head over there, because the Four of Pentacles was in that reading as well. Cancer, you're dealing with somebody who's, okay, they're closed off, right? When you're feeling neglected from the connection, if you're new here, this is how I read. I read up and down and across. This is the story of when these things are happening. So while you're feeling neglected from this connection, this person is holding on to their feelings. They're not opening up. So I do feel like within due time, this person is going to want to bring back balance in this connection. But I feel like when they're closed off to you, they definitely are giving attention to other people with the Six of Pentacles. One of these people in the card are getting breadcrumbed there, and then the other person is waiting for their turn. So the combination of cards on their side is very closed off emotionally. Giving and receiving with a lot of people, possibly more than just you. And, you know, and I only say that because we also have the Knight of Wands as well. He's the in and out, action-oriented energy. So it's like this person is closed off, but when they want generosity from other people, they get on their horse and they come. So, Cancer, this is like literally reminding me of your November reading. This person, they leave you out, they neglect you. Patience, you got to be patient because this person's going to take a second. And then they come back. And then it probably happens again because the Knight of Wands cannot sit in one place for too long. Very, very, very strong Sagittarius energy here, Cancer. And you know, Sagittarius, they're the archer. They do not stay in one place for too long. Sagittarius adventures out. They get bored easily as well. So I feel like this person, they're just all over the place. And they're just very closed off emotionally with this Four of Pentacles. They don't want to open up. We have a lot of Pentacles as well. Could be a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. But very strong Sagittarius. So let's get the mutual energy. But this person may just be acting like a Sagittarius. It may not be a Sagittarius. But for some of you, this person is a Sagittarius. So let's clarify the mutual energy here for my Cancers and the person they're dealing with. And I literally said this to you in your love reading for November. The neglect, it only lasts a certain amount of time. And it's like you can always count on this person to come back. But unfortunately, you can always count on this person to leave. But once you can always count on them to come back. Like that's what it is. So let's get the mutual energy here. They do want to bring back balance. Within due time, they will come back to your energy. So let's see. The mutual. Okay, Cancer, we have strength, Leo energy. Yeah, you both pull back. It's like you get neglected, you get left out, you feel hurt, and you pull back. This person just doesn't open up, so they're just pulled back all the time. Or when they want to be. All right, in the mutual energy, we also have the Star. Yep, when they come back, they bring balance. They bring hope to the connection. They bring peace to the connection. You think it's actually going to go somewhere. And then we have the Lovers. Yeah, so there's constantly a choice to be made. There's constantly reconciliation with this person. And this person is just... oh. Could be dealing with a Gemini, an Aquarius, or a Leo. So in your mutual energy, you have Leo. You have Aquarius and you have Gemini. All majors. So it seems to me like this cycle has been happening multiple times. I felt the same way with your November reading. But Cancer, they're coming back. They're going to want to heal with you. They're going to want to find hope in this connection. They're going to want to say something. I don't really know exactly what they're going to say. You do have the Page of Swords on your end. So it may be an immature communication. I do not like the way the Page of Swords communicates. But there's going to be a choice between the two of you. Do I let this person back in? Do I not let this person back in? I really feel like this could be anybody. A new person, a past person, the current person you've been dealing with that's just been flighty. But Cancer, you're dealing with somebody who's very flighty. And yeah, I just feel like this person is just, it's like they have, this person is like confusing me because they have some sort of passion for you. At least they have passion. Let me clarify this last row, Cancer. Can you clarify this last row? I need Cancer's energy, the mutual energy, and this person's energy that Cancer's connecting with. Okay, Cancer, for you, we have the Ten of Cups. In the mutual, the Ten of Wands, Knight of Wands, the Empress. Ooh, gosh. Okay, so, this is so, I knew it, I felt it. I'm like, why do I feel so much happiness? Cancer, I hate to say it, but this person, you know, I feel like when they come around, they give you this real large happiness that they're back. But man, when they leave, it's like you feel like the world is ending. Or you feel like very left out. But Cancer, I'm telling you, if there's one thing you can rely on this person to do is to come back and to leave. So I'm going to clarify this once more. We do have the Ten of Wands, so you can tell that you are burdened by this connection. And when they do come back, you've put the burden down. because they're coming into your energy. We do have the Empress as well, so you may have a child with this person or definitely strong intimacy here. So please clarify, Spirit, this bottom row. One more time. We have the Five of Wands, the Knight of Cups, and the Ace of Cups. Ooh, Cancer. This person is very confusing because they're confusing me, and I can see how much they are confusing you. So like I said, Cancer, when you are neglected by them, it's like the worst. But when they reach out to you, I feel like this person could say anything and you're happy. But the Five of Wands, this person is going to always cause conflict somehow. I feel like they cause you to feel insecure in the connection because you don't know the security of this connection because this person is so flighty. And this person, they come so heavily. They come like they are ready for commitment. They come to you like this is all they've ever wanted. They come to you like you're their one and then they leave you out. So just be a little bit weary of this person. But Cancer, they're coming back. They have an Ace of Cups for you. They may be a bit, they may say some emotion to you. They may try to get your emotions riled up here. But with this Knight of Cups as well and the mutual energy, I do feel like you both go from being closed off to open, to closed off to open. So let's get the Moonology card. So this weekend, I definitely feel like if you haven't heard from this person, you're going to hear from them this weekend. For sure. I don't know how long they're going to stay in your energy. So I'll see y'all for the dailies next week. So let's get a Moonology card for Cancer. Okay, Cancer. We have adjustments are required. Third quarter moon. Yeah, there needs to be some sort of, this needs to be adjusted. This can't keep happening. I mean, it could keep happening, you know. Whatever you put up with is going to continue. So, I feel like Cancer, oh yeah, there's got to be some sort of adjustments. I feel like this person needs to get it together and pick a side. You either want Cancer or you don't, you know. That's how I feel. Like, pick a lane, person. Honestly, I feel like they need to adjust. And I feel like, Cancer, you may need to adjust as well. And stand your ground. Put up a fight. I don't know. Put your foot down or something. Yeah, that's how I feel. That's all I'm getting. Honestly, I don't hear anything else. So, Cancer, you could be dealing with most of them. We do have the Empress here, could be a Libra or a Taurus, and could be dealing with almost any sign. So, Cancer, thank you for being here. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you very, very soon. Okay, let's move to my Pisces, because I went a long time on Cancer. What am I at here? Ooh, long time for Cancer. Okay, so hello to my Pisces, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs for my Pisces for this weekend. Spirit, how are my Pisces feeling in their love lives? Spirit, how are my Pisces feeling in their love lives? Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs, how are my Pisces feeling? Show me how Pisces is feeling this weekend in their love life. What's going on? Okay, Pisces, we have the King of Swords. We have the King of Wands. Ooh, Pisces, look at you. And we have the Moon. Okay, Pisces, so I feel like you're hiding your feelings right away. I got that. We have Pisces energy here. Could be dealing with an Aquarius, Gemini, Libra, a fire sign, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. But this is you, Pisces. You are not, ooh, Pisces, what the heck's going down here? You are not playing around. You are saying to yourself, look, if you don't have my best interest at heart, you're going to get cut off. That's how I felt with that card. King of Wands. I feel like you are nurturing something in your life as well. Definitely maybe on a creative pursuit, but I feel like you looking really good. with that King of Wands. I feel like everyone's noticing you. I feel like you are, you know, I feel like you're very detached emotionally, Pisces. I feel like you're very much standing your ground. I feel like you are taking care of yourself. You are looking good. You're smelling good. People are recognizing you. But the moon is here. So you're hiding some sort of feelings. And you may be hiding these feelings behind this King of Swords. And that's why your King of Swords is the first card out. But if you're not hiding feelings, Pisces, you may be having dreams about something that's happening in your love life with the moon. It could be that moon energy is also amplifying your love life. Like something may have happened to you during a moon cycle. So maybe something happened to you on the Taurus blue moon or around there or whatever the case may be. Let's see your person's energy. I feel like a lot of you Pisces have feelings for somebody, but you're hiding them behind your, I guess, sexiness and your detached nature. So, let's see. Because, you know, Pisces, we are the emotional people, but honestly, I mean, I'm just talking from my experience. I do have Aquarius in my chart, though, so that may be why. But when we want to pull back, do we go. So, here we go. Let's get the person that Pisces is dealing with here. Pisces. The person is coming through as the Eight of Cups. The Seven of Swords. And the Six of Swords. Ooh, Pisces. So I feel like the person that you're dealing with, they have just left something. Who? They may have just left you or... There is some sort of energy here of deception, but I feel like this person wants to heal this deception, or they don't want you to see them as being deceptive. Pisces, I feel like you may think you're being deceived by this person. Let's get the mutual energy here. You may be thinking, oh, okay. I feel like Pisces, you may be connecting with somebody that you think it may want you for intimacy only. And you may be really pulled back because you don't want that only. Weird. Very weird. Very, very... Their energy is interesting here. I feel like Pisces, this person, they either walked away from you recently or before and possibly cheated on you, deceived you, left you for somebody else, whatever the case may be. And now they want to heal with you. Now they want to move forward with you. Now they want to have some sort of compromise. Maybe, you know, they just want to talk about it and move through it. Maybe they don't want a second chance per se. But there is something happening where somebody's either returning back to you wanting to heal this, or you have some sort of energy in your life that they may have gone through some sort of ending where they are walking away from somebody and they're moving towards you. And I don't know. I feel like some of you Pisces, you may think that this person is deceiving you or this person wants you for intimacy or something. Let's see. Clarify the mutual energy between Pisces and this person. Very strong Aquarius, Gemini, Libra. Could be a fellow Pisces, water sign. Give me the mutual energy spirit for Pisces and this person for this weekend. Pisces, I feel like if this is somebody who has left you for somebody else or cheated on you or whatever, and they want to move towards you, they want to see you, I don't know if you are going to want to see them. I don't really think so. But let's see. We have, the Queen of Wands in the mutual energy. We have the Nine of Swords. And we have Judgment. Oh, gosh. Okay, so Pisces, I feel like you're connecting with somebody who walked away from you in the past. And I feel like they're walking back towards you. I feel like there is a lot of passion between the two of you with this Queen of Wands. I do feel that way. But I feel like Pisces, you're at the point where you don't want the passion. I kind of feel like you don't even want to deal with this person. You're like, if I'm attracted to you or not, I don't really care. We also have the Nine of Swords in the middle. So there's a lot of stress over this. There's a lot of... I really feel like some of you Pisces, you think that this person is coming back for intimacy with you. And I don't know how you... I don't feel like you are liking that. Or it's really driving you crazy. But honestly, this person is overthinking this connection just as much as you are, because they did walk away from you, because you are now detached from them, because you are now emotionally not available for them. You are sitting pretty and you're like, look, I know you want this, and I know you, now you know you can't have it. I feel like some of you Pisces, you're not going to give in. I don't think so. Some of you Pisces, you may, but I don't think you're going to open up emotionally. I think you're going to be very detached. We do have judgment here, so there is a return of somebody coming from your past. I don't feel like this is new energy at all. If this is new energy, then I feel like Pisces, you may already be dealing with somebody else, and this person is coming, and we're just picking up on this person because of how much anxiety there is and how much overthinking there is on this connection. I'm going to clarify this last row. I need Pisces energy, the mutual energy, and this person's energy. I really do feel like some of you Pisces think that somebody is using you for intimacy. Or they're coming back for that only. So, the Moon, the Seven of Pentacles, Judgment, the Devil, yeah, thank you, Spirit. The Six of Swords, the Five of Swords, yeah. So, Pisces, somebody wants to see you. And I feel like you are on point. I feel like you are like, well... Until I see that this person actually wants something different than maybe just sex, or I don't know, I don't feel anything else, then you're just waiting to see if this person will say something differently. And I don't feel like they will. I feel like the attraction between the two of you is extremely strong with the Devil. Could be dealing with a Capricorn. I feel like the attraction with this person is through the roof, or it was through the roof. I don't feel like for Pisces it's that bad anymore. I feel like you're the one who's way more in your power than this person is now. But they want to move towards you. They, Six of Swords, Five of Swords. They want to come towards you, and they don't have good intentions, Pisces. They don't. Their intentions are bad. They may have walked away from somebody else to come towards you. Maybe they weren't being fulfilled where they were, and they're like, nope, Pisces, I know Pisces got it going on. I'm coming towards Pisces. Pisces, this person, next, next, next. You know who this person is as well. You know who keeps coming back for some sort of intimacy. Or you know who only has intimacy in their mindset and nothing else. But I'm telling you, Pisces, this person, if you let them move your way, Five of Swords. You're going to go right to the Five of Swords. Six of Swords to the Five of Swords. You're going to move backwards letting this person in, Pisces. So let's get the Moonology card. Sorry, Pisces, but sometimes the readings are not going to always be great. You're sitting in your power. I feel like you don't care. So Pisces, I feel like some of you may already be dealing with somebody else. This person's coming your way. They're tempting you. There may have been a lot of overthinking with this person, but you're not letting it get to you anymore, Pisces. You know what this person is. You know they're a thief. You know they're sneaky. You know they're a liar. And that's all. That's what I got for you, Pisces. So we do have the King and the Queen of Wands, so definitely intimacy is really highlighted here. Sexual, passion, creativity. But Pisces, you're not. I feel like you don't. I feel like this person wants to move in your direction, but I feel like they're going to feel defeated. The defeated energy is on their end. And I feel like it's because you're not giving in. Let's get the Moonology card for Pisces, Spirit for Pisces. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. Let's get some advice for Pisces. Could be dealing with any sign. I have almost all signs. I don't have any cups here. Oh, I do have cups. Could be dealing with any sign. There you go. All right, Pisces, here we go. We have you and your loved ones are safe. New moon in Cancer. Perfect and amazing clarification from Spirit. We love that. But with that card, I think somebody got that too, Scorpio. I said I always like to pull another one after, because that one's just a very sweet reminder, you know? We want something else. We want something different. We want something different. So let's see. Let's get another one. It always, when that card comes out first, I always give another one. So here we go, Pisces. Let's get another one. You and your loved ones are safe. Somebody needed to hear that. You may have been feeling a bit stressed over health in your family or something. So here we go, Pisces. Don't let pride get in your way. Full moon in Leo. Ooh, Pisces. Full moon in Leo. Could be dealing with a Leo. Maybe you have Leo in your chart. Maybe your moon sign is Leo or rising, maybe Venus, whatever the case may be. Pisces, spirit, I feel like, you know, yeah, you want to close off to this person, possibly. I do feel like you're going to talk to them somehow, but I don't really think you're going to let them in. Some of you may, some of you may not. But this person is just, they don't have good intentions. So some of you, Pisces, you know this and you don't really speak on it. Maybe it's time to say something. Maybe it's time to reject this person and maybe that's what's happening. So Pisces, thank you for being here. Thank you for watching and I'll see you very, very soon. Bye now. All right, and now we are going to do my air signs, my Geminis, my Libras, and my Aquariuses. Hello, hello, hello to my Geminis. Welcome to your weekend love reading. Spirit, how are my Geminis feeling this weekend? Please show me Geminis energy, sun, moon, rising, Venus signs. How are my Geminis feeling this weekend, Spirit? All right. Gemini, we have the Hermit, the Four of Swords, and the Three of Wands. Okay, so Gemini, I see you in solitude. I see you healing. I see you looking within with the Hermit, could be dealing with a Virgo. I see you reviewing and reflecting. You're healing parts of yourself that need to be healed. You may be having some dreams here as well, Four of Swords. You definitely could be taking a break from love or just healing the connection that you're in or wanting to heal the connection that you're in. But Gemini, I do see you coming out of this with the Three of Wands. I do see you coming out of this hermit mode, out of the slumber, right? Sleeping here. Maybe you're actually healing from something, Gemini. You may have some sort of sickness, health issue, something along those lines. And you are finally going to be getting out of this and looking towards the future of a brighter future ahead, for sure. I did feel that way in your November reading for love as well. So Gemini, I do see you, you're not doing much, but I feel like you're ready to do something now. So let's see what your person's up to. Spirit, what is Gemini's person up to? Who is Gemini connecting with this weekend? I just see you very, very reviewing, reflecting, and really trying to heal the parts of yourself that need to be healed for you to really gain a better perspective on life and really also have a brighter and more optimistic approach in love. So let's see, who is Gemini connecting with, Spirit? You may be in separation from somebody as well, because I don't really see much action on your end, Gemini, just yet, but I do see you moving out of hermit mode. So let's see, your person is coming through as the Two of Cups, the Six of Cups, and the Lovers. Gemini, I feel like you could be connecting with somebody who chose somebody over you. And I think they want to come back into your energy. I feel like they miss you now. For others of you Geminis, I definitely feel like somebody wants to connect with you, and you're not really giving them anything. So I only feel two stories here, Gemini. Either one, you are connecting with somebody that has left you for somebody else, and they are coming back with the lover's energy at the end to reconnect with you. And for others of you Geminis, I feel like somebody's been trying to connect to you. Somebody's been seeing you as a soulmate connection. Very strong soulmate connection. This person loves you here. And if this person chose somebody else over you, oh man, they are missing you like crazy. And they want to come back into your energy. Nonetheless, whatever the story was, Gemini, this person wants to come back into your energy very strongly. We have the lovers, Gemini energy, the Six of Cups, the Two of Cups, soulmate energy. So you may be in separation from this person and they want to come back. Let's get the mutual energy here, Spirit, for Gemini and this person. Who is Gemini dealing with? Can I please get the mutual energy between Gemini and this person? Could be a family friend, could be a friend from a long time ago or a past lover from your childhood. Let's see, Spirit, what is the mutual energy between Gemini and this person? I feel like Gemini, if this person chose somebody else over you, they are now choosing you. And that's why you've been not really doing anything towards this person. Let's see, Spirit, the mutual energy. If that's not the case here, Gemini, then you are meeting a soulmate energy, or a soulmate energy is returning back into your life. They miss you. They want this. They love you. And they definitely want to start over. So we have the Page of Wands in the mutual, the Ace of Pentacles, and the Queen of Pentacles. Yeah, they are coming. And that may be why you are coming out of hermit mode, because this person is going to be coming in hot. This person is either Spirit, clarify the Two of Cups on Gemini, who this person's side, who's Gemini connecting with, because that's where I feel like they may have left you for someone else in the past. So Spirit, why is the Two of Cups here? And if that's not the case, this person, oh my gosh, the Emperor. Ooh. Gemini, the person that you are connecting with, that you will be connecting with, that you are reconnecting with, this person, honestly, I don't know if this person dated somebody else to make you jealous or what, or they dated somebody else to see if they can gain control over you, but it didn't work. So yeah, but we do have the Page of Wands and the mutual energy. There is passion here. They want to re-spark the spark. And for a lot of you Geminis, this is a new energy that either maybe you know this person from your childhood, but this person looks at you as their one. They look at you as somebody that they could be with for a very long time. There is an offer of commitment on the table between the two of you. Are we going to restart this? Can we restart this? Or do you want to start this? Because I do feel like for some of you Geminis, this could be new energy that is a past life soulmate connection that you are finally able to meet. Because you did do all of this reflection and all this healing, Geminis, a lot of you healed a certain part of yourself that was blocking this person, and now they are unblocked. I do feel like there's commitment on the table. I feel like there's going to be a choice of commitment. I feel like this person is going to know they want you right away. And if they didn't know they wanted you before, Gemini, just be ready, because they're coming in heavy. They are definitely going to be a bit emotional towards you, possibly. Could it be a Scorpio, a Pisces, or I don't know why I said Taurus. It could be a Taurus, but it could be a Cancer as well. It could be a Taurus, a Virgo, a Capricorn, strong Virgo. So, Gemini, this person, oh, they love you. They love you. They love you. And if they are new, then this is a very, very strong connection that there is potential for a lot of love and a lot of stability. And if you're already in a relationship with somebody, I feel like for I don't know if you're healing from something, Gemini, or what, but I feel like this person is willing to take the lead on this connection and really show you sweet love, take care of you, and really, oh, it's beautiful. It really is beautiful. And even if it is somebody who chose somebody else over you, I still feel the sweet, beautiful energy because they have come to the decision that you are who they want. And they are really deciding this with the Emperor. Aries energy could be dealing with. They are really deciding you're it. And they're taking control and taking the lead on you knowing this. So let's get a Moonology card for my Geminis. Somebody's coming, Gemini. Someone's got sweet love for you. Someone's got sweet love. They're either coming back or they're coming or they're already here. And they just want to, I feel like this person wants to take care of you. I really feel that way. So Gemini, your Moonology card is you and your loved ones are safe. This keeps coming out, new moon in Cancer. So a lot of you definitely may be dealing with some sort of illness, depression, something there. And that is beautiful confirmation, Gemini, that you and your loved ones are safe. I am going to pull another card there because I always do that. Scorpio got that card and so did Pisces. And now it's again for Gemini. So definitely Spirit is wanting to let a lot of the collective know that the depressive thoughts or negative thoughts are all in your head. You and your loved ones are safe. So we also have the energy is gaining momentum, waning moon. Yes, Gemini, the energy is gaining momentum because this person is finally deciding to come your way, or this person has finally made the choice to come your way and choose you. Or I really feel like, Gemini, the person that you're connecting with, whoever you're in a relationship with, I really, really, really feel like this person, they want to take care of you. They want to help you. They want to nurture you. They want to take the lead on this partnership and really be all that you've ever wished for. And I feel like a lot of you Geminis, like I said, Three of Wands, you're getting ready to choose a new path, the brighter path. And that's why the energy is gaining the momentum for you to have a better, brighter, wonderful future. But Gemini, this person that's coming back, they have so much love for you. Or this new person that you're meeting, there is so much love to be shared with this person or the connection you're in. I really feel this really strong, sweet energy. So Gemini, beautiful reading. Thank you for being here. Thank you for watching. I'll see you very, very soon. Bye now. All right, Gemini's done. We're going to do my Libras. Hello, hello, hello to my Libras. Welcome to your weekend love reading with me, Miss Machiste. Libra, let's get into it. Let's look at your energy. Spirit, can I please have Libra's energy? Can I please have Libra's energy, Spirit? Please show me Libra's energy for this weekend. Spirit, please show me Libra's energy for this weekend. All right, Libra, let's see. We have the Seven of Pentacles, the Fool, and the Ten of Pentacles. All right, I gotta say it. Some of you Libras are getting unexpected money. Right away, I see that. Unexpected raise, unexpected check in the mail. Unexpected proposal. Because you go from the Seven of Pentacles, waiting for more abundance. And then you get the Fool, Aries energy, a new beginning of full abundance, Ten of Pentacles. So you're getting blessed here, Libra. I feel like some of you have been waiting for a proposal, or you've been waiting for like the next step in your relationship. Maybe you're getting married. Maybe you're getting proposed to. Maybe you're just leveling up. It's going from just talking to boyfriend and girlfriend or whatever the case may be. A lot of you Libras, you're getting some sort of unexpected money. All right, so let's see what your person's up to. Who is Libra connecting with, Spirit? Who are my Libras connecting with? Who are my Libras connecting with? You're just going to feel really stable, Libra. And I feel like you haven't felt stable in your love life in quite some time. And you're going to feel more stability for sure. You may be embarking on a new journey at a new job or something too. So let's see here, Libra. You may work with this person with all these pentacles as well. Could be a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. So who is Libra connecting with? Let's see. All right, Libra, we have the Empress. There you are. Libra, Taurus energy. We have the Three of Cups and we have the Five of Wands. All right, so there's some sort of something going on here where, I feel like some of you are getting proposed to. I do see a celebration. And I have been feeling that way for a lot of you Libras. I do see some sort of reconciliation as well. But for others of you Libras, I feel like you're connecting with somebody who goes out a lot. Or they spend time with their friends a lot. Or they drink a lot with this Three of Cups. For others of you Libras, I feel like this person, they want to take you out. But I feel like whatever this Three of Cups is causes conflict. So, I do feel like for a lot of you Libras, this is some sort of... I'm just going to move this a bit because I feel like the lighting is weird. All right, whatever. Okay, so Libra, you know, this person... this is how I feel. The person you're connecting with or you will be connecting with or whatever the case may be, it's like they see your growth. They see your value. They see your abundance. They want to nurture this connection. They definitely nurture themselves. They definitely put energy into themselves. But I feel like you're waiting for more, Libra. I feel like you're waiting for more from them. I really do feel that way. I feel like you're like, okay, well, you see my value, but why don't you treat me that way? I feel like that. We do have the Three of Cups as well, so I do feel like this person does want to come together with you. They do want to have some sort of reconciliation with you, but this could also be this person goes out a lot and it causes conflict, or you may meet someone out. You may meet multiple people out, Libra. So I have a lot of stories here, so let me go to the mutual energy. So Libra, it's either, I have three stories. It's either you've been waiting for a proposal and there's a good chance it's coming. For others of you Libras, I feel like you have an issue with your person because they go out a lot. Or you want to be taken out. It's one or two. It's either they go out a lot, this person you're dealing with goes out a lot, or you want to be taken out. And third story, Libra, you are meeting somebody new, and I think you're going to meet them out. You may be single for quite some time, waiting for a new beginning. So let's put the mutual energy here. I feel like, Libra, you may be meeting multiple people out. Because we do have the Five of Wands, so you may have people fighting for your attention. Okay, clarify, Spirit. Can I please have the mutual energy? Sorry, I sing stuff sometimes. I don't have the best voice, but it just comes out. So, Spirit for Libra, please clarify Libra's energy with this person. The mutual energy, please. Can you please give me the mutual energy between Libra and this person for this weekend? All right, we have the Ace of Wands. We have the Six of Swords. And we have the Knight of Cups. Okay, so I do feel some of you Libras, yeah, you definitely want to be taken out for sure with this Six of Swords, this Ace of Wands. I feel like you just want more effort from your person. And I feel like you're going to get it. I just feel like it may be not as quick as you thought it would have been. Because there is a need to have patience on your end as well. But we have all signs out here. The only majors I have are the Fool, which is Aries, the Empress, which is Libra or Taurus. So, you know, Libra, I feel like you could definitely be connecting with somebody or been in connection with somebody. I feel like you're either waiting to be proposed to or you're waiting to be taken out. You're waiting for this connection to level up somehow. And it's kind of like Libra. I feel like if this connection doesn't level up, you want to focus on you. I do feel that way. I feel like you're like, okay, well, I can't rely on you, so I'm just going to do what I'm going to do. But there is a Ten of Pentacles on your end, so you're either extremely stable, or this is a very long connection that you've been in, possibly a marriage. And I don't know, you want to do something with this person. You want to do something. Go out, do something. I feel like I felt this way for one of your, I think it was Libra too. But for others of you Libras, I do see you going out. And I see you meeting somebody. I see you meeting multiple people. So one of the people that you will be connecting with, I feel like is a bit of a jealous person. Or they are definitely willing to fight for your attention. Even if you do have other people involved. Because Libra, I do feel like whoever you're connecting with, there either is some issue with the fact that they don't take you out. Or that they go out with friends a lot. And it may cause arguments between the two of you. They may go out and drink, have fun, whatever the case may be. Or you are actually going out and meeting this person. And I feel like you're meeting multiple people. And this one energy is like, I'm willing to fight for you, Libra. Could be dealing with a water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. But there will be emotion between the two of you. Or there is emotion between the two of you. So let's get the Moonology card for my Libras, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus sign to close out this reading. Definitely Libra, I feel like you're going to get some raise or unexpected money. And sorry, that has nothing to do with love, but that's a great message to hear. But you want more. I feel like Libra, you're ready for commitment. Keep in mind, this could be totally vice versa, okay? So let's get the Moonology. And this is just the weekend reading. Libra, the November readings for love are already out in the November 2020 playlist if you want to go check those out. So your Moonology card is nothing is yet set in stone. Mutable moon. That's beautiful. I love that card because whatever conflict you're having with this person, or whatever, maybe you're having some sort of conflict with finances, or conflict with the fact that this person goes out a lot, or conflict with the fact that they never take you out, or like I said, you're going out and you may have been waiting for some sort of attention or waiting for some sort of celebration here. And with Mutable Moon, this card comes out, you got to be ready for anything. Because nothing is yet set in stone. So whatever you assume is going to happen is probably just a negative thought of yours. Spirit wants you to know nothing is for sure yet. So definitely keep pushing. And I really feel like for some of you Libras, you have an issue with this person going out and getting attention from other people or something. Or maybe you do it to them, Libra. It could be vice versa. But nothing is yet set in stone. Mutable moon, mutable signs, they can adapt to anything. You know, we can all adapt to anything, but mutable is the word you would use to be very adaptable. So honestly, Libra, you may have had a problem with the fact that this person isn't going to take you out and you thought they would never, and now you're going to be pleasantly surprised with going out. So, a lot of things going on here, Libra. Expect money. That's all I got to say here as well. So, thank you for being here, Libra. Thank you for watching. And I'll see y'all very, very soon. All right, hello, hello to my Aquariuses. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. Spirit for my Aquariuses. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs. For my Aquarius's spirit, can I please have how are my Aquarius's feeling this weekend? Please show me how are my Aquarius is going to be feeling this weekend. Spirit, please show me how will my Aquariuses be feeling this weekend. Sun, moon, rising, Venus sign for Aquarius. All right, Aquarius, let's see. We have Strength, the Queen of Wands, and the Devil. Ooh, Aquarius, I feel like you're tempting someone. I feel like somebody is very tempted by you, or you're feeling very tempted by somebody else. I feel very intimately, sexually here with the Devil. You may feel very tied to this person as well. Capricorn energy here. I feel like you're going to be tempted by someone or someone's tempting you. That's the first thing I got in my head. Others of you, if you're in a relationship, I feel like it's a bit toxic. It may be toxic opposed to the fact that, because of the fact that maybe it could be you, Aquarius, but it could be other person. I feel like one of you likes attention from other people. So let's get this person's energy. Could be dealing with a Leo as well with Strength. Queen of Wands, Sagittarius, Leo, Aries. So a lot of fire here, a lot of passion coming through. So Spirit, what is in Aquarius's person's energy? What is in Aquarius's person's energy for this weekend? Okay, we have the Five of Wands, the Five of Cups, and the Queen of Swords. Okay, Aquarius, oh my gosh. Oh man, I feel like you're tempting this person and they do not want to let the temptation get to them. Ooh, they are having such a hard time with this, Aquarius. This person is feeling extremely conflicted inside. They're feeling extremely challenged with your energy. I feel like they're very tempted by you, but I feel like I don't know what you two have been through, or maybe they get a vibe from you. Maybe this is a new person and they get a vibe from you that you... You know, I do feel like, Aquarius, you're the one who gets attention from other people. It could be the other person. It could be roles reversed, but maybe this is why this person is upset or this person is disappointed. But, you know, it's like they're trying to fight you off anyways. They're trying to fight off this feeling anyways. They're trying to fight off the fact that you make them feel this way. So, Aquarius, this could be a new person, a past person, a current person. Whatever the case may be, when you pull back from them, they feel conflicted. But when you're in their energy, they still feel conflicted because I think they lost hope in this connection, or they don't have hope that you're going to commit to them. Ooh, my goodness. Could be dealing with a fellow Aquarius, Gemini, or Libra. Could be a water sign, Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. So let's get the mutual energy. Ooh, I don't know if this person's going to let you get to them here, Aquarius. But boy, are they tempted here. Let's get the mutual energy between Aquarius and this person. I feel like, Aquarius, you may not even have to do anything. And this person is tempted by your energy. They may say something to you as well with the Queen of Swords. They may want to speak their truth. They may speak their truth of how you make them feel, like, all over the place. So let's see, Spirit. And I also just did your November love reading as well. And I did see somebody coming through heavy with communication. So could be why this Queen of Swords is here ready to speak up. So, Spirit, can you please give me the mutual energy between Aquarius and this person for this weekend? Who is Aquarius connecting to for this weekend, Spirit? Okay. All right. All right, Aquarius, let's see what's going down. We have the Eight of Pentacles. You both are working on yourselves still. Putting the work into you, because I don't feel like anybody's really putting much work into this connection that much. Maybe, possibly not. We also have the Sun and the Ace of Pentacles. Ooh, there's an offer on the table. All right, definitely could be a Leo or somebody with strong Leo in their chart. You may have Leo in your chart, but there's going to be clarity on how someone feels. There's going to be clarity on this situation if you have felt like there is not clarity. One or both of you, it's in the mutual energy, so I feel like somebody is planning to offer something with this Ace of Pentacles. Somebody is planning to offer, maybe you want to get together, maybe you want to see each other. Whatever the case may be, this Ace of Pentacles is being worked on, and you will have the clarity on this connection. I do feel like there's going to be communication. I really feel like you really tempt this person, Aquarius. I'm going to clarify the last row. I really feel like you tempt them. Who's the offer from? I feel like they're going to say something, so it could be from them, or maybe you guys have a conversation, and it's like, you know, well, maybe we should get together and talk about this. I don't know how this person's going to feel, because I feel like they're very tempted by you. They may want to only talk. I don't know. Oh, let's see, Aquarius. Let's clarify the last row. Spirit, I need Aquarius's energy, the mutual energy, and the person Aquarius is dealing with. This is why these very quick weekend readings that are you versus them get so crazy, especially when the offer is in the mutual energy. All right, Aquarius, on yours, we have the Devil with the Hierophant. Oh my gosh. What you doing there, Aquarius? We have the Ace of Pentacles with the Five of Swords. Oh, Queen of Swords with the Empress. Yeah, I feel like this, Aquarius. I feel like there's a lot of lessons to learn with this person. I do feel like with the Ace of Pentacles and the Five of Swords, I do feel like there's going to be conflict around this coming together. So whoever offers it, you know, I don't really see that, who it is. I feel like it could be them because they have the Queen of Swords and the Empress, so they may want to try to have growth with you. But we have the Hierophant. So, you know, Aquarius, this is Taurus energy on your end. The Hierophant is traditional. They do what they please. And, you know, that's it. That's Aquarius energy. Aquarius's energy, they are like, you're full not on people pleasers, but then you are. It's interesting. It depends what side of the Aquarius is you, Aquarius energy you lie on. But there's going to be an offer to get together. But I feel like you both feel defeated by this offer, because I don't really think neither. I don't know. I feel like this person is more commitment focused than you are, Aquarius. Let's get a Moonology card. Nonetheless, there's an offer on the table. I feel like you both want to get together with each other, but it's almost like you both feel like you don't know if it's going to go anywhere if you do get together. This person may choose their growth over this connection. You may choose what your tradition is or what you want to do or how you feel things should go over how this person feels things should go. Because I do see there may be some sort of conflict around this offer. So, and I feel like it's because of the temptation between the two of you, and maybe there's a non-commitment here. And it kind of looks like it's going to be committed, but then it really isn't. So let's get a Moonology for Aquarius and this person. There's a lot of spiritual lessons attached to this person with the Hierophant, though. So this could be worked through. I definitely feel that way. Okay. We have nothing is yet set in stone. Mutable Moon. Someone just got this. Libra just got this. And y'all saw me shuffle. So, Mutable Moon. Definitely things are going to change with the tides. So, you two pulling back from each other is not going to last long. You two being disappointed in this connection is not going to last long. This conflict over this offer is not going to last long. But there needs to be some sort of something of some sort of stability to this connection. And I feel like there's going to be a talk. Because neither of you know where this connection stands. That's why Mutable Moon is here. Everything is up in the air. Anything can change at the drop of a pin with this connection, I feel. We have 3 5s, which shows change. 5 5 5 indicates change. We also have... Oh, I'm sorry. We have 4 5s with the Hierophant. 5 5 5 5 indicates change. And Mutable Moon, things will change. So a lot of you Aquariuses, this may have not been the best reading that you were hoping for, but things are going to change. And that's one thing you can count on in this life, is that nothing is going to stay the same forever. And that could be comforting for some and scary for others. But in this case, it's comforting because there's a lot of conflict here that needs to be worked through. I think it can be worked through, but there needs to be a talk. All right. That's all I got for you, Aquarius. That's how I feel. You could be dealing with a Taurus strongly, or a Libra, fellow air sign, a Leo strong, and a Capricorn. Everybody else is out on the table. Could be dealing with anyone. Bye now, Aquarius. See you soon. All right. Let's do the fire signs. Fire, fire, fire. My Aries, my Leos, and my Sagittariuses. My Sagittariuses. Okay, sorry. I just like to sing. All right, here we go. We're going to do my Aries spirit for my Aries sun, moon, rising, Venus sign. Hey to all my Aries out there. Comment your sign placement. I'm an Aries rising. I would love to meet some Aries, sun, moon, risings, or Venuses, whatever the case may be. So comment your placement, Aries. So let's get into it. For my Aries, how are my Aries going to be feeling this weekend? Show me for my Aries in their love life. All right. Aries, we have strength, the King of Swords, and the Justice card. Strong Libra energy, Aries. You're not playing around. You're really being analytical and logical. Ooh, with this King of Swords, could be dealing with a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. But Aries, I feel like you're very detached emotionally. I feel like with Justice as well, you're ready to do what's right. You want to bring back balance. You could be receiving some good karma as well. We also have Strength, Leo energy. You may have been regaining your strength. You may have been very hurt. I feel like a lot of you Aries have been extremely hurt in love, in the current relationship you're in the past, whatever the case may be. I feel like you're waiting for your justice from this hurt. I feel like you're waiting for your good karma, your justice, for things to be balanced in your love life from what you have been through. And let's see. Spirit, can you please give me the person's energy who's Aries dealing with? I feel like there's a decision you have to make to Aries. Because, you know, the King of Swords, he is logical, he's analytical, but, you know, he also makes decisions. Justice is making a final decision as well. So maybe you've just gone through a divorce, and that's why you're very closed off, possibly pulled back. You want your justice, you want your peace, you want your balance here. So who is Aries connecting with, Spirit? Give me Aries's, who are they connecting with energy? Okay, Aries, we have the Three of Cups. We have the High Priestess. And we have the Ten of Swords. Yeah, there could have definitely been some sort of ending in your relationship, or an ending to a cycle of a relationship. I definitely feel like could be a full-on ending. This person may have ended things with you. They may like going out with their friends, Aries. Or you may like going out with your friends, and that's why they ended stuff with you. I feel like this person could be a Pisces, a Virgo. Cancer, a Scorpio, or a fellow air sign. Not a fellow air sign. A Aries, what am I saying here? A Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Some of you are dealing with an air sign. That's why I just got so tongue twisted on that. But it's almost, I don't know, this person's pulled back too, but it's almost like they want to, either they want to reconcile with you, or there was some sort of issue with this person that you have ended things with or have been ended with, that there was some issue. They liked going out a lot or something. They may have liked drinking, or there was some third party situation here. So let's clarify the mutual, let's put the mutual energy out. Spirit, what is the mutual energy between Aries and this person? So I have two stories here, Aries. I feel like you definitely just gone through an ending with somebody. It's over. It's done. This person has pulled back. You have pulled back. You want your justice. It's over. And for others of you, Aries, I definitely feel like there is some issue around a third situation. So either going out and being with friends, or just being with friends in general, or possibly a drinking problem, or maybe somebody lies, or maybe, you know, Aries, this person may lie about when they are out, and they may be ending the lies, and that's maybe how you're getting your justice. Because for some of you, Aries, I feel like there is a connection that you're still in, and this person may be ending some sort of secret. Okay, Aries, this person may have been having an affair that they're just ending right now to be with you. Or they're ending lying or something. Okay, let's clarify the let's put the mutual energy out, Spirit, for Aries and whoever they're connecting with. If you have just gone through an ending with this person, Spirit is saying, Aries, you will get your justice. Just be patient. Things need to process first. So in the mutual energy, Aries, we have the Nine of Wands, the Six of Cups, and the Six of Pentacles. Yeah, so for a lot of you, Aries, it's done, it's over, it's been done, it's been over. And, you know, you may have to make it work for a kid or something. You may have to compromise for a child with the Six of Cups and the Six of Pentacles. Spirit is saying, do it. Bring back the balance, because the more balance around you, the more balance can happen for you. So if you've just gone through an ending and you have to go through some sort of custody or whatever the case may be, you share a child with this person, whatever you feel is your story, I do feel like there's going to be some sort of compromise with them, some sort of balance with them. Honestly, you know, and I'm not trying to give anybody no false hope, but Aries, somebody may have ended something with you and they may want to come back, and you may be very standoffish towards this person, but them returning to your energy is still you receiving some sort of karmic justice. They may want to bring back balance here with you, Six of Cups. They may definitely want to come back into your energy and bring back balance with the Six of Pentacles. For others of you, Aries, it's over, it's done with. There has to be some sort of compromise for a child or something, or maybe you work with them. And third story I'm feeling for Aries, I feel like you're in a connection, you're in a relationship, whatever the case may be. Somebody goes out, or somebody spends so much time with friends, they lie about it, they lie about being out, whatever the case may be. I feel like they're done lying with this Ten of Swords. I feel like they want to bring back more balance and reciprocation with you. They want to have more give and take with you, some more sincerity and more truth, because they have feelings for you with the Six of Cups. And I feel as though you have feelings for this person. This is not you having a child with somebody, or this is not you having some person that ended things with you come back. I definitely feel like for a lot of you, Aries, who are in a connection or just going back and forth with somebody, they want this. They have feelings for you. You have feelings for them as well. No matter what they do and no matter what they lie about here. So let's get a Moonology card here for my Aries. Nonetheless, Aries, you have justice coming your way. So somebody has either been lying to you and they're going to stop, or you are, you know, it may be a blessing in disguise that something ended for you, okay? You may not be extremely happy about it, but trust me, you will be happy about it. You may have to compromise with this person because of a child. All right, let's get a Moonology card for my Aries. Whoa, we're flying. For my Aries, Spirit, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus sign. What do we have for my Aries, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus in their love lives? All right, Aries, we have faith in your dreams, waxing crescent moon. Yes, Aries, some of you need to have faith in the fact that this ending had to happen. Some of you need to have faith in the fact that this connection is still salvageable even after this person lies. And for others of you, but you know, Aries, don't let this person disrespect you. You know what I'm saying? I do see you very standing your ground, for sure. I see you wanting to bring back balance and do what's right. But Aries, if this person's been lying to you, don't let them off that easy, you know? I don't think you will, though, with this King of Swords, Justice. I feel like you're really going to stand your ground. And for others of you, Aries, you know, if there's been an ending, even if there was no compromise or whatever because of a child or whatever the case may be, Spirit wants you to know, I'm going to bring back balance into your life. But you have to trust me and you have to have faith in your dreams and have faith that I will bring you good karma. Because we do have Justice here and we have the Six of Pentacles and they both have Libra scales in their cards. So Justice will come. But you gotta believe it, Aries. You can't just sit and dwell on the ending, okay? So thank you for being here, Aries. Thank you for watching. I'll see you very, very soon. All right, and hello, hello to my Leos, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus sign. For my Leo, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, Spirit, how are my Leos going to be feeling this weekend in their love lives? Can I please have for my Leos, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus? Okay, Leo. We have the World, the Three of Wands, and the Eight of Pentacles. All right, Leo. I see you putting work into yourself. You may have just ended something with somebody or have closed out a cycle in your current relationship and looking towards the future of a brighter future for this connection. The World, you may live at a distance from this person, but I feel like you're ready to put effort into something. Three of Wands, Eight of Pentacles. I feel like you are preparing for a brighter future, so you are putting the work in because you know it's going to happen for you. Beautiful intention, manifestation energy. That's one of the manifestation keys, intention. So you want to learn about it. I'm going to be doing a manifestation series, Leo. So subscribe and hit that bell because it's going to be coming out this month. Anyways, back to your reading. So Leo, I feel like you're right. I feel like you've closed out a part of your love life. You've closed out a cycle. Maybe you've been single for quite some time. And I feel like you're ready to put work into somebody, or you've been putting a lot of effort into you with this Eight of Pentacles. And I feel like you definitely may be having somebody come your way that also wants to put this effort into you. So let's clarify. Why do I keep saying clarify? Let's get your person's energy here, Leo. Because I feel like you're just ready to put effort into things, or you are ready to believe in yourself in love. And maybe you didn't believe in yourself before, or maybe the cycle that you were in with this person was toxic and you both are like, no, you know, like, let's start over. Let's put more effort into each other. Let's try more. You know, I feel like you're ready to try more. So let's see. For my Leos, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, who are they connecting with for this weekend? All right, Leo, we have the Ace of Cups. Beautiful. We have the Queen of Swords. And we have the Fool. Yes. Leo, you definitely could be dealing with an Aries, a Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio, or an Aquarius, a Gemini, or a Libra. Strong Aquarius, you may have it in your chart. They may have it in their chart. I feel like, you know, this could be new love. I feel very strongly this is a new person. They may not be new, but it's new to you. You're navigating this. I feel like, Leo, after a very hard cycle, you are finding new love. But I feel like, you know, Leo, I feel like this person with the Queen of Swords, this person is very independent. This person is very analytical, very logical. This person is very communicative, but they may be very straight to the point, not very emotional with their communication. But I do feel like this person wants to take a risk with you. This person wants to start new with you. They want to start fresh with you. They want to take a risk on this connection. And I feel like, Leo, you're finally ready to take a risk as well. So, you know, with this Ace of Cups, it could be new love or it could be renewed love. Like I said, you and your person may be like, you know what? Let's really try this time. Let's put in a lot more effort than we've ever put in before, because maybe we're not putting enough effort. And I feel like that's what's happening here. So I feel like, Leo, it could be a new person. I really feel that way with the Ace of Cups. But keep in mind, because we have the Ace of Cups and we have the Fool and we have the Three of Wands. So the Three of Wands, they choose the third path. And we have the World, which shows me that something ended. So let's get the mutual energy between you and this person, Leo. I feel like, Leo, if this is a person that you've been connecting with for quite some time or been in a relationship, I feel like you're finally choosing to try more. And this person is finally, and this person also wants to take the risk too. This person has love for you. This person wants to take a risk. They want this second chance. They want this new beginning. But I don't know, something may have happened between the two of you that turned this person a little bit cold. Maybe, Leo, you did something to them, hence why you are, I do see you wanting to put more effort. But it could be vice versa as well. Keep in mind, you may be on their side, they may be on your side. Let's get the mutual energy for Leo and this person. Also, Leo, some of you may have somebody interested in you and you're very focused on you and you're not looking up. But I feel like you will look up at this person. So what's the mutual energy between Leo and this person? Okay, Leo, we have the Eight of Cups, the Devil, and the Page of Pentacles. Yes, starting new, starting fresh, a new person, or a second chance for this relationship. I do feel like this connection, if this is somebody that you have been with, I do feel like it was toxic, and that's what closed out. Could have been a Capricorn. I feel like you, let's put him this way. Even though it's this, I feel the same message, but it's easier for you to understand. Walking away from the Devil energy, walking away from the codependency, the toxicity, the fears, the doubts, the arguments, the problems, the issues that no longer serve this connection. I feel like you two are walking away from this. And I really feel like there is a fresh new start for a lot of you Leos, where you both are going to put more work into this connection. This person is, they're ready. They're like, I'll take the risk. I don't care, Leo. You're worth it. And for others of you Leos, this is a totally new person. And I feel the same. I feel like they have been hurt. But I really feel like, you know, Leo, this person's ready to take the risk. Could be a Capricorn with the Devil in the middle. But it could be a Taurus as well. But Leo, look at this. This Page of Pentacles. This is lucky energy. This is very lucky energy. So somebody either wants to start something with you. They want to build with you. They want to grow with you. And Leo, it may have not come after until after you walked away from something. So if some of you Leos are still stuck on somebody inside of your heart, and you still have these Eight of Cups of emotion for something that no longer serves you, you gotta choose a third path. Choose that third path. Put the work into you because it's going to reap rewards. You are getting somebody coming towards you. It doesn't have to be a woman with this Queen of Swords. It's just the way this person is coming out. So let's get a Moonology card here. There is no gender in tarot. But Leo, a lot of you need to let go of old and outdated fears, old and outdated beliefs about love or about this connection. So Spirit, can you please clarify? Can you please give me a Moonology? I keep saying the word clarify. Moonology for Leo, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus sign. The Devil is also here, possibly showing that there's a lot of sexual tension between the two of you, or if this is a new person, there definitely will be. So let's see, Leo. We have Believe in the Impossible, Blue Moon. Leo, a lot of you are definitely coming together with a new person, and you never thought that you would feel this way about someone ever again, and you're pleasantly surprised with yourself and pleasantly surprised with this person. And for others of you Leos, maybe you just never thought that this connection would have a second chance. Maybe you never thought that you two could work through this Devil energy. Maybe you never thought that you two could close out the cycle, right? We have the World on your side. We have the Fool on their side. Some of you didn't think that you would be able to find a new beginning with this person or have a second chance with this person. And Spirit wants you to believe in the impossible, Leo, because either you have this blessed new love coming your way with the Ace of Cups. They have emotions. This person is, even if this person is coming through as the Queen of Swords, they are still emotionally available. They are just independent. They're analytical. They are logical. They won't full on drown you in the emotion. So maybe you and this person had to get to this point. Possibly the person that you were dealing with may have drowned you in a lot of emotion, and now they're learning, all right, I need to be more in this Queen of Wands because my Leo doesn't want to be drowned in emotion. You know, that may have been an issue before. But a second chance in your love life, Leo. A second chance because you're meeting someone new and you never thought. Or a second chance because you never thought this relationship would start over again. But you both have to walk away from the fears and the doubts. It's not just them and it's not just you. It's both of you. So for the people who are meeting somebody new or have been connecting with somebody new, this person also has to detach from their fears and doubts on love as well. So Leo, thank you for being here. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you very soon. Bye now. Okay, and to my Sagittariuses, hello, hello to my Sagittariuses, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs. For my Sagittariuses, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus sign. I don't know if my Sag moderator's on this because I'm pre-recording it. But Savvy, hello, and a shout out to you. My first ever moderator on the channel. So, let's get into it for my Sagittariuses, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs. For my Sagittariuses, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. Let's get into it. How are my Sagittariuses feeling? All right, Sagittarius. On your side, we have the Five of Wands, the Ten of Pentacles, and Temperance. All right, Sag, you may be having some conflict at home or some conflict with your stability and your money. Maybe some conflict in your marriage as well. But with the Five of Wands there, this is showing challenge, insecurity, possible jealousy. So also, Sagittarius, you may have multiple people wanting your attention with that Five of Wands. You may have multiple people wanting your love and attention, and it may be extremely conflicted for you because you are unsure of what to do. So we also have the Ten of Pentacles here. So your money's looking good. And if your money hasn't been looking good, it will start looking good with Temperance coming through at the end. There you go, Sagittarius energy. So let's get a couple more cards for your person. Who is Sagittarius connecting with? Who is Sagittarius connecting with for this weekend? All right, Sag, let's see who you're connecting with if the cards want to stay. All right, here we go. First Sagittarius, who am I Sag is connecting with this weekend? All right, we have the Queen of Cups, the Seven of Cups, and the Four of Wands. Yeah, I feel like Sagittarius, I feel like you either have options or your person thinks they're an option to you. If that's not the case, then this person may have options. I don't know if that's... For some of you, yes, yeah, Sagittarius, person may have options. That may be why you're conflicted. But if this person doesn't have options, I feel like they're very confused. I don't feel like they know how you feel. For a lot of you Sagittarius, I feel like you have options and you're focused on your money because there is some sort of money difficulty or there has been. So you want to make sure it doesn't happen again. So I feel like this person that you're connecting with definitely could be a Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. I feel like this person has feelings for you or they will be very emotionally driven. So they're going to use their emotions for a lot of the things here. So honestly, Sagittarius, I do feel like you have people around you, multiple people in your energy. You know, you could be in a marriage and there is a lot of confusion and conflict over finances. That's how I feel. And Spirit wants you to know that there will be happiness again. There will be stability again with this Four of Wands. It just must take patience. There must be patience. And I feel like, you know, Sagittarius, you may be holding your ground better than this person is. This person may be very confused and very up in the air and very not having a lot of faith that you guys are going to get your finances together. But you will. That's only for my people who are married. And also for my people who are married, you definitely may be dealing with some sort of other energy. Maybe somebody's causing you conflict externally to this connection. Possibly somebody is interested in your man or your woman. So I feel like you both are looking confused and you both are looking conflicted a bit. So for some of you in marriages, there definitely may be some sort of something where somebody's interested in your spouse. But don't worry about it, Sagittarius. Nothing's going to happen here. I don't see that doing anything. And for others of you, Sagittarius, I really do feel like you're going to be connecting with somebody soon or you have already connected with them. You may meet them at a ceremony. You may meet them out with this Four of Wands. This is not always marriage. So in this spread, yeah, I do see that there could be marriage. But for others of you, Sagittarius, I do feel like you're meeting somebody out or you may meet someone out. I feel like you may meet multiple people out. And I feel like this one person is very confused and in fantasy land about you. Honestly, I want to say for others of you, Sagittarius, I feel like you have somebody who's interested in you. And I feel like you're really focused on your money or there's some conflict around money for you. And this person, it's making them feel like they're an option to you. Because you're not focused on them fully. Or they may think you have options because you're not focused on them fully. Ew, what's going on, Sagittarius? There's a lot here. It's like the messages are nonstop right now. So let's get the mutual energy and then we'll get more. For Sagittarius, the mutual energy between this person and Sagittarius for this weekend. Okay, we have the High Priestess. We have the Nine of Wands. And we have the Knight of Pentacles. So yeah, my people who are resonating with the money situation, money is going to get better between the two of you. It's just going to not be as fast as you anticipated, but it will be slow and steady. It will not just disappear. So please have patience for my Sagittarius's who are having financial issues. Have patience, especially if you're having financial issues with your person. Have patience. It's coming. Okay. And I feel like a lot of you, you've been really pulled back because of this financial issue, and really you feel like you've been fighting forever. You may have actually had arguments with each other because of this. With this Nine of Wands, the High Priestess pulling back, not really wanting to do much. For others of you Sagittariuses, I feel again the same way. This High Priestess, I feel like you both are somehow withdrawn, trying to listen to your intuition. Either in connection or when you first meet each other, because I do feel like this could be either or. I really feel strongly this is more for people who are in connection or in on and off connections, but this could definitely be a new person, but I don't feel like you're interested in them. I feel like they're having the conflict on confusion that you are not interested, so you may even totally just miss this person, Sagittarius, but the High Priestess, pulled back energy, trying to use your intuition. Could be a Pisces, very strong Pisces, could be a Virgo. We have the Nine of Wands, which is showing that you both are a bit blocked out, but I feel like this person's blocking you out because they're confused and they think you're an option. I mean, they think they're an option to you, and I feel like you're just not focused on love right now. You're focused on money. And I feel like this person thinks that it's because you have options when in reality you're focused on money, but hey, you know, some of you Sagittariuses, you do have options and you do have multiple people fighting for you. And this person, I feel like they're intuitive and they can feel that. So that may be why they're a bit pulled back as well. But with the Knight of Pentacles here, there is some sort of slow progress with this person. So there is going to be progression forward with this Knight of Pentacles. It's going to show more growth and more stability, but I just feel like it's going to take some time. I feel like Sagittarius, this person is very interested in coupling with you. This person is very interested in bringing the peace back to this connection and bringing the happiness back to this connection. And like I said, if money has been getting you down, single Sagittariuses or in relationship Sagittariuses, Spirit wants you to know you will have happiness restored with this Four of Wands. Sorry. This Knight of Pentacles, slow but steady, temperance, have patience, and also have faith as well. So, Sagittarius, you definitely may be meeting somebody this weekend, or somebody has their eye on you this weekend, and I don't really feel like you're paying attention to them this weekend, but I don't think they're going to give up, Sag. I don't think they're going to give up. And for others of you Sagittariuses, I do feel like there's some sort of money issue in your relationship that is going to get better. But y'all are stressing it. And you may be taking it out on each other. So let's get a Moonology card for my Sagittariuses, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus sign. And this is just a throw out there that somebody may resonate with this. I feel like Sagittarius, you may be connecting with somebody and you're in a relationship and they're in a relationship. Yeah. So. But within due time, there's going to be some progression for the both of you. But I do feel like for some of you Sagittariuses, you're in a connection, they're in a connection, and you both are confused on what to do because you want each other somehow. So that's only for some of you. Let's get a Moonology card for Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus for this weekend. We have Step Out of Your Comfort Zone, North Node. All right. Yeah, I do feel that. I do feel like some of you Sagittarius, you're just going to like, you may not give this person that much attention this weekend. Or you may not even realize that somebody wants your attention. Spirit definitely wants you to step out of your comfort zone for sure. That could also mean for you in connections to step out of your comfort zone. Maybe there's a different way to make money that you have not figured out. Or maybe you're just staying in what you feel is familiar, and that's not going to work. You have to spread out to something that's new. And for others of you, Sagittarius, like I said, you may be very focused on money, and that may be your comfort zone. Your stability may be your comfort zone, and you may not want to be emotional, or you may not want to spread out your energy or give your stability or give your reliability to another because you're so focused on yours. But Spirit is saying, step out of your comfort zone. I really do feel like this person is very interested in being with you and being happy with you, but they're just confused. They may be fantasizing about you as well, or having dreams about you with the Seven of Cups. Strong water sign energy, specifically Pisces. But we have all signs out here. And we have Sagittarius. So you may be connecting with a fellow Sagittarius, but things are going to get better, Sagittarius. Things are going to be more peaceful, more happy, and more reliable where things have not been that way. So keep in mind, Sagittarius, roles could be flipped. This could be the other way around. But thank you for being here, Sagittarius. Thank you for watching. And I'll see you very, very soon. Bye now. Okay, and for my earth signs, my Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. We're going to start with Taurus. Hello, hello to my Tauruses. Welcome to your weekend love reading. We're going to be looking at your energy, their energy, and the mutual energy. So Taurus, let's see how my Tauruses are doing. Ooh, this weekend. Taurus, if you want, you can go check out the November love reading that's already posted for your sign. Spirit for Taurus, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. Can I please have their energy for this weekend? Okay, Taurus, we have the Queen of Cups, the Nine of Wands, and the Ten of Pentacles. Okay, Taurus, your vibe is like reminding me of Sagittarius's. I mean, you kind of got the same cards in there spread, just in different areas. I feel like you're blocking out your emotions somehow, or you're contemplating giving your emotions. Queen of Cups, Taurus, could be dealing with a Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces. But I see you resting, and I see you reconsidering giving your cup away. I see you very focused on your money. I see you blocking things out. The wounded warrior here, he's hurt, he's bandaged. He doesn't want to deal with more pain. So you may be feeling very sensitive right now, Taurus, or you just don't feel like dealing with emotions or the pain that comes with being vulnerable. Ten of Pentacles, definitely focused on your money. You may have some money coming your way as well. Maybe you're focused on a family matter as well. So let's see, who are you connecting with, Taurus? Spirit, who is my Taurus is connecting with this weekend? Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. Who is Taurus connecting with, Spirit? Thank you. Okay, Taurus, we have Strength, the Ace of Wands, and the Tower. Okay, well, Taurus, you're not ready for anything, or you're not necessarily fully open for something, but somebody's coming your way. We have Strength, Leo energy, could be a Leo. I feel like this person, they have been regaining their strength and willpower for quite some time. They may have been hurt by you, or they may have just been hurt by love in general, but they want to reach out to you, Taurus. They want to say something here with the Ace of Wands. They will say something with the Ace of Wands. Definitely could be through the internet or through some sort of social site or on your phone with the Ace of Wands. They have an idea for you, Taurus. Do you want to get together? Would you like to see me? How do you feel about building this, or what do you feel about growing this? How do you feel about me? The passion is here. So Taurus, definitely could be a new person with the Ace of Wands. Or it could be somebody from your past or just something you weren't expecting from your person with the Tower. Because some of you Tauruses could be in a relationship already and you're just not focused on emotions. But I feel like your partner is going to pleasantly surprise you here with the Ace of Wands. Maybe they want to re-spark the spark, be intimate here a little bit differently. Maybe they've been holding back their intimacy from you. Maybe you two are going to do something creative together. Whatever the case may be, they have an idea for you, Taurus. They want to know how you feel about it. Others of you, Tauruses, I definitely feel like this could be a new person you just were not expecting to meet. Or Taurus, with, I mean, the Tower is on their end as well, so they may have been very surprised that they met you. They may have been very shocked that they met somebody like you, Taurus. But, and for others of you, Tauruses, I do feel like this could be just somebody that you know. Past, current, new, definitely could be somebody new or somebody that is from your past, whatever the case may be, reaching out to you, and you may be very shocked by this, that they have even said anything to you. So let's get the mutual energy between Taurus and this person. Nonetheless, there is a shock. And I feel like this person's shocked too, which is weird. Okay, let's see. Let's clarify what I mean. I'm sorry. Let's get the mutual energy for Taurus and this person. Taurus, your reading for November was about you mirroring somebody or somebody mirroring you and stuff like that. And one of you saying something, so now I see something here in the weekend, so interesting. Definitely go check that out as well. So let's see the mutual energy. We have the Three of Pentacles. We have the Seven of Cups and the High Priestess. Okay. Dare I say, Taurus, that this person's going to build up the courage to reach out to you and you're going to reject them? Ooh, some of you, Taurus. And they may be shocked that you reject them. Yeah. I feel that way with some of you. I feel like Taurus, this person is... I feel like the person from the past or somebody that you've been connecting with or whatever the case may be, they're going to gain some courage to reach out to you. They're going to say something. And I think you pulling back on them is going to shock them. We're going to clarify this a little bit because I'm like, what the heck? Okay, so we have the Three of Pentacles in the middle. So there's definitely a need for you and this person to work together. You may be meeting them out with this Three of Pentacles. You may have worked with this person or you know them from work or something along those lines or school or wherever. Three of Pentacles is just a third party or a third situation where you would meet somebody at. So you may have met them on a social site. You may have met them through a friend. You may have met them at a bar. You know, the bar would be the third energy. So I do feel like you both are confused. I feel, you know, I already felt that with you, Taurus. You're very, you don't want to be vulnerable. I see that already. And I feel like this person is also confused on how to communicate with you or how to, how to express themselves to you. There's a lot of confusion here. But with the Seven of Cups in the middle, there's a lot of fantasy as well. So you may be meeting a new person and you two are fantasizing about each other. And no one is really doing much except for fantasizing. Because we do have the Seven of Cups and the High Priestess. This combination is fantasy land. This is also dreaming as well. So you, Taurus, you may have dreamt of this person. This person may have dreamt of you. You know, you got to go check out that November love reading that I just posted because I felt like I think Fifth Dimension came out and that would be your dream state. So if you're a Taurus that's watching this that's been having dreams or Taurus cross watcher, go check that out. Could be dealing with a Pisces or a Virgo. I'm going to clarify this last row because this person, Taurus, wants to say something to you. This person will say something to you, but I'm not sure how. I feel like they're going to be shocked that you don't say anything back. or they're shocked by your response. Let's see. It's either they're shocked that you ignore their offer, or they're shocked by your response. So let's see. Clarify this last row for Taurus, the mutual energy, and Taurus, the person they're connecting with. Taurus, the mutual energy, and the person they're connecting with. Okay, Taurus, we have the moon on your side. A lot of fifth dimension cards coming through. A lot of dream state type things. And a lot of hiding emotions as well on your side, Taurus. We have the High Priestess with the Six of Wands. All right, all right. And the Tower with the Ace of Pentacles. Ooh.
Taurus.
They're shocked by your response. I do feel like them reaching out to you first may open the gates for you a little bit. I don't feel like you're going to express how you feel, and I don't feel like you're going to express much to this person, whether it's a new person or a current person or whatever the case may be. You're definitely holding a lot back with the moon and the Ten of Pentacles. You may be actually holding back that you want a relationship, or you're holding back that you don't want one. One or the other. You know, Taurus, you know. But it's almost like you two had some intuitive insight. I feel like, Taurus, that you may have had intuition that you were going to meet somebody new, because this could be somebody new. Or you had intuition and this person had intuition that you were going to be receiving attention from each other. But the Six of Wands, attention, you know, wow, Taurus, this is so much like your November reading. I mean, granted, I just did do it like 2 days ago, so the energy is still fresh. And for a lot of you, the energy has not manifested into 3D yet. And I see that here. But Taurus, I feel like this person's going to say something, and I feel like they're going to be shocked by what you say back. Because we have the Ace of Pentacles with the Tower. So there's definitely going to be some sort of offer to do something here. I feel like they're going to be shocked at what you say back, and they're going to offer more. So I think you do have a good response, or you say something. You give them something here. They remember I said Ace of Wands. They're going to reach out to you with an idea. Hey, Taurus, this would be awesome if we did this. Or it would be so cool if we did that. Or whatever the case may be. It could have just been a hey or a hi. Testing the waters. Seeing if they could get into your energy. And then once they are shocked by your response, or maybe that you even did respond, I think they're going to offer more with this Ace of Pentacles. I feel like this Ace of Wands is them testing the waters. The Ace of Pentacles is them going for it because they're shocked by the fact that you even answered or that you are interested. So I do feel like this could be a new person that you're meeting. I feel like they don't think you're interested in them, Taurus. Or this is just somebody that you've been mirroring, or you've been mirroring each other. Definitely could work with this person with the Three of Pentacles, or you're meeting them at a third party area somehow, some way. Ooh, let's get a Moonology card for Taurus. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus for Taurus. You could be dealing with almost any sign here, Taurus. I have Pisces, Virgo. I have a strong Pisces, actually, with the Moon and the High Priestess. I have Capricorn, Scorpio. I have Leo. Yeah. Any other sign you could be dealing with. I have Cups out. I have Wands out. I have Pentacles out. I just don't have any Swords out. But you could definitely still be dealing with an air sign. So let's see here what's coming through for my Tauruses. Spirit, what Moonology card do you have for Taurus for this weekend? You both want each other's attention. I feel like neither of you just want to be the first person to say something. And like I said, this could be the new person you're meeting. Just feeling your vibe. And they're just like, I feel like they're a little bit scared to come towards you, Taurus. But here we go. Your Moonology card is you and your loved ones are safe. New Moon in Cancer. This is such a hot card for these weekend love readings. If y'all rewind, there are like four or five signs that got this card. And whenever this card comes out, I always pull another one. Because yes, it's amazing confirmation that you and your loved ones are safe. So there's definitely some sort of fear that the collective is having right now. Possibly the collective is having fear of getting corona or fear of some sort of destruction. Definitely could be dealing with a Cancer, Taurus, or you have Cancer in your chart. Let's get one more. And we have, look at the bigger picture, full moon in Sagittarius. Yeah, there's a lot going on. There's a lot of hidden energy here, but I feel like there's going to be a little bit revealed. Not all of it is going to be revealed. I feel like this person is going to reveal more than you do, Taurus. But man, you both are hiding the fact you want each other's attention. And Taurus, don't comment like, no, 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 because this could be a totally new person that you haven't met yet. And you're like, oh my gosh, Miss Machise did tell me I was going to want this person's attention. So they want your attention just as bad, if not more than you do. I do feel like this person is a tad bit more interested than you are. But you may be interested and you may be just great at hiding it. Because I do see the moon with the Ten of Pentacles. So that's either that you're hiding the fact that you're focused on work and money or a lot. And that you're not ready for commitment. Or you're hiding the fact that you actually would commit. Could be either or. But thank you for being here, Taurus. Thank you for watching. And I'll see you very, very soon. And to my Virgos, Virgo, Virgo, Virgo. I don't know if anybody watches this whole thing and watches my little sayings in between the signs. Okay. Virgo, hello, hello to my Virgos. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs. For my Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus spirit in their love lives. How are my Virgos feeling for this weekend? Show me the vibes for my Virgos spirit. For this weekend, please show me my Virgo's energy spirit for this weekend. What are my Virgos feeling this weekend? Virgo, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs. How are my Virgos feeling this weekend in their love lives? Okay, Virgo, we have the Two of Swords, the Knight of Wands, and the Six of Pentacles. Okay, Virgo, I feel like you have, some of you, Virgos, may have multiple people interested in you. I feel like you have a choice to make, so I do feel like, Virgo, you have multiple people interested in you, or you just got a lot going on. You may have your heart blocked right now. With the Two of Swords, could be dealing with an Aquarius, Gemini, Libra. But I feel like you're very action-oriented right now. I feel like you're all over the place with the Knight of Wands. If that's not the case, you may be dealing with somebody who's like that. But I do feel like, no, I feel like, Virgo, for a lot of you, this is you. You may be dating around or just trying to see what's going on here. We have the Six of Pentacles as well. So, Virgo, you may be taking care of stuff. Taking care of something, getting your pentacles right. Virgo, I feel like if you're in a relationship, I feel like you're doing a lot. I feel like you're doing a lot of movement and you're doing a lot of like earthly type things. You're not really full on opened with your heart here. I feel like you're just trying to make things work in the connection as best as you can. For others of you Virgos, I do feel like you got a lot of people interested in you. I feel like there's a choice to make between who you want to deal with. And for others of you Virgos, you may have this one person who just keeps returning back into your energy. Let's see. Spirit, can you please give me who is Virgo connecting with? You could be dealing with a Sagittarius or a Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Who is Virgo connecting with for this weekend? Who is Virgo connecting with, Spirit? Who is Virgo connecting with this weekend? Spirit, who are my Virgos connecting with this weekend? All right, Virgo, we have Strengths. This is a hot card, too. We have the Empress and the Knight of Pentacles. Okay, so Virgo, I feel like your person has been through a couple different things. I feel like, you know, whoever you're connecting with or will be connecting with, I feel like they really see the growth in you with the Empress. I feel like this person is good at nurturing and you're good at nurturing as well. Could be a Libra, could be a Taurus, but I feel like this person sees a lot of value in you. They see a lot of value in you. I really do feel like some of you Virgos, you're taking care of something in your relationship. I don't know why I feel that way. You could be taking care of your person. But they look at you as so valuable. This person wants to give you their reliability and their stability. They may be a bit slow with their reliability and their stability, causing you to feel like they are giving their energy to other people, but I feel like they want balance with you. I feel like you're the one who's all over the place for a lot of you Virgos. I feel like you're the one who may be exploring and dating around. Keep in mind, it could be vice versa. But I feel like, you know, Virgo, there's a choice to be made. Like, do you want to let this person in? Do you want to bring balance to this connection? Or do you want to continue exploring? Do you want to continue to see what's out there? Because I feel like this person, they see your value, or they are going to see your value right away. And I feel like Taurus, why do I say Taurus? Oh my God, you could be dealing with a Taurus. Virgo, I feel like for a lot of you Virgos, it's going to cause you to choose between the single life and the committed life. So, interesting. So, yeah, some of you could be dealing with a Leo, the Empress, Libra, or Taurus, Knight of Pentacles, Six of Pentacles, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Sagittarius with the Knight of Wands could be a Leo or an Aries, but let's see what the mutual energy is between the two of you. Honestly, I feel like Virgo, it's your choice. This person sees your value. They see your growth. They see your worth. Yeah, they're a bit slow with their reliability and their stability, but they want to have balance with you. And I feel like they're only interested in you. I feel like you're the one who has to make a choice between if you want to continue to be single or give them a chance. So let's get the mutual, let's get the mutual energy for Virgo and whoever they're connecting with this weekend. I just feel like, you know, I feel like you got a lot to take care of. I don't know why I feel that way. You may be getting a lot of asks by you. People are asking you favors, or you got a lot to take care of. Wow, that train is really loud. Okay. So for my Virgos, mutual energy for Virgo, my beautiful, wonderful Virgos. What's the mutual energy between this person and Virgo? Okay. Virgo, we have the Hermit. There you are. We have the Four of Swords. There you are. There you are. That's not you. Oh. Okay, here I go. We also have the Six of Wands. Sorry. Okay, so Virgo, there you are. The Hermit. Mutual energy coming between the two of you. You've both been reflecting. You've both been reviewing. You've both been healing deep parts of yourselves. And really, really trying to become a better person or become a new person or just better than the person that you were in the past. Not saying you were ever a bad person, but there's always room for improvement all the time. And I feel like Virgo, you both know this and you both are doing that if you are in a connection. I definitely feel like there's a lot of healing that's going on between the two of you with this Four of Swords as well. Could be a Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. But I feel like you're going to have victory with each other, the Six of Wands. This person wants your attention, Virgo. I feel like you're going to give them your attention. I feel like you're going to like their attention as well. I feel like for a lot of you Virgos, if you're in a connection, like I said, Virgo, you have a lot to do. This person wants your attention, for sure. There may have been a little bit of a separation here or a little bit of a timeout. but I don't feel like it lasted too long. Or there's just some sort of... I feel like Virgo, you have other things to take care of. And this person, they may felt the neglect. I don't feel like they felt it too heavily. I just feel like they just see so much value in you. And they may actually rely on you somehow. And for others of you Virgos, I definitely feel like you're meeting somebody new or you have been in connection with somebody. And I feel like it's a choice. Virgo, are you going to stop your exploring and stop your dating life to commit to this person or to see if this person is worth your commitment or whatever the case may be? Or are you going to continue on your search and keep this person as one of your people? Nonetheless, there is victory with the Six of Wands. There's going to be recognition and appreciation with this person. And they want your attention. You want their attention. And there's going to be more balance in this connection than there was before. Or there's just going to be a lot more balance in your love life than there was before. Because I feel like for a lot of you Virgos, maybe you weren't sitting in the driver's seat of your love life. And you were letting a lot of other people take control. But now you are in control, Virgo. So, let's get a Moonology card for my Virgos, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus sign. For my Virgos, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs. For Virgo, I really feel like this person, Virgo, they are just looking at you like you're magnificent. You're amazing. As they should, right, Virgo? Mm-hmm. Okay, so let's get a Moonology for Virgo. We have a time for healing. I said that. Balsamic moon. No. No, it looks like balsamic, you know, like balsamic vinaigrette. Okay, a time for healing. Virgo. I felt that there was healing between the two of you too with the Hermit and the Four of Swords. So for some of you that are in a relationship, get ready for a whole new relationship with this person because you guys are healing parts that had to be healed, and congratulations because there's going to be a lot more balance and a lot more security and stability. And for others of you, you've been healing for quite some time. Maybe, you know, Virgo, you have been healing and exploring at the same time. But I do feel like there's going to be healing with this person because this person is just going to be, whoever this is, whether they're coming back from the past or this is a new person, they're just seeing your worth, they're seeing your value, they're seeing everything that is wonderful about you, Virgo, and it's just amazing. It's just amazing energy here. So they are really, they're ready to offer you something. And I feel like this is going to be a very healing connection for you. And a very healing connection for them. And like I said, Virgo, you have a choice. Are you going to open up your heart or are you not going to open up your heart? Do you feel like you've healed enough? Do you feel like you're ready to open up? Because for a long time, it's been a time for healing. And now it's time for you to be recognized, Virgo. So, thank you for being here, Virgo. Thank you for watching. And I'll see y'all very, very soon. Okay, and last but not least, my Capricorns. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus signs for my Capricorns. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. Hello, hello to my Capricorns. Let's get into it for Capricorn. Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. Can I please have Capricorn's energy, Spirit? What is Capricorn's energy for this weekend in their love lives? What is Capricorn's energy? All right, Capricorn, we have the Five of Wands, the Nine of Pentacles, and the Eight of Swords. Ooh. I feel like, Capricorn, you have you're either feeling conflicted about somebody and restricted, but you feel good, though, with this Nine of Pentacles. You still feel on top of your game, but I feel like somebody may be feeling you, maybe making you feel a bit insecure. It's weird, right? Like, that's contradictive. It's like you feel good, but then you feel insecure. If that's not the case, you know, I feel like, but you could feel that way. We can have 1,000,000,000 feelings at once. For others of you, it's almost like you feel good in this connection, like you feel recognized, or you will be feeling recognized. But I don't know if this, what this per, let me see, because I feel like this person may be causing you the restriction. So let's see what they're doing. What is the person that Capricorn is dealing with doing? What's their energy? Who is Capricorn dealing with? Capricorn, your November love reading is out if you want to go check it out. Ooh, look at that. Flipped right on you. And I normally never show y'all anything, but Capricorn. Okay, let's get into it. Who is Capricorn dealing with? Could be dealing with a fellow Capricorn because that flew. It didn't fly, but it's flipped over. So let's see. Capricorn, your person has the Seven of Pentacles. They have the Eight of Wands. And they have Justice. Okay. Capricorn, I feel like your person is waiting for something. You know what? I feel like y'all are both waiting for something. I feel like you both are waiting for somebody to make a move or to somebody to make the move. I feel like Capricorn, you don't want it to be you. I feel like you want it to be them. That's why you feel a bit restricted in your thoughts. And that's why you're feeling a bit all over the place. So either Capricorn, you have multiple people interested in you and you don't know who to pick. Or you're feeling extremely insecure in a connection and a bit restricted because you don't really want to say anything. You don't really want to express your restriction or insecurity because you don't really feel restricted. Like you only feel restricted and insecure because of this person. When you're not dealing with this person, you're good, you're fine. But this person makes you feel some type of way, so they make you feel a little bit restricted. So we have the Seven of Pentacles. This person's waiting for something with the Seven of Pentacles. This person may be contemplating if they want to give you something or if they want to say something to you. We also have the Eight of Wands. So this could be intimacy. That may be what's going on here. You know, Capricorn, you may be very attracted towards this person and you may be feeling a bit restricted because, you know, there may have not been any intimacy, or maybe you don't want to make the first move to be even not even like go the whole nine yards, but maybe even like just showing more passion to each other. I feel like you're a bit nervous on doing that. I feel like this person, it's not that this person is nervous either, but it's like, I feel like Capricorn, I feel like you want to stay respectful. For some weird reason, I feel like you want to be respectful towards this person. I feel like this person wants to be respectful towards you as well. But it's almost like they want to be respectful towards themselves too. And you the same. So very interesting. I feel like you two are like mirroring each other in a way. Not full on, but kind of. But we do have Justice. So I feel like this person has a choice to make, a final choice to make with Justice. And I feel like, Capricorn, if you've been connecting with somebody, I feel like it's like, are we gonna show each other more love? Or are we gonna keep acting like we don't have feelings for each other? That's how I feel. Are we gonna show each other that we're attracted to each other? Are we gonna show each other intimacy and love and playfulness and passion? Or are we just gonna act like we don't feel that way about each other? And for others of you Capricorns, I feel like you may be single for quite some time. And you may have somebody writing to you or reaching out to you, wanting to have a conversation with you that makes you feel very conflicted. They make you feel very restricted. They make you feel in your head. And you're like, no, I'm good. Like, I can't let this person get to me, but they still do somehow. Could be a Libra with Justice here. So let's get the mutual energy between the two of you, because Capricorn, it's almost like this person knows how to get your feelings all crazy and your thoughts all crazy. And if that's not the case, then Capricorn, I feel like you've been in a connection with somebody, or you've been in an on and off connection or something along those lines, where neither of you want to make the first move, I feel like. All right, let's see. Let's get the mutual energy between the two of you. I feel like you both are trying to be respectful to each other, but inside you're like dying. So let's see. Let's clarify the let's put the mutual energy out for Capricorn and this person. Okay. We have the Four of Cups. We have the Page of Wands. I'm telling you, for a lot of you Capricorns, it's who's going to make the first move. Mm-hmm. And we have the Wheel of Fortune. Yes, things are changing. Things are going to shift. This stagnant energy, this even boredom energy, because you two may be like, just dating and just going on dates and not really getting close to each other and kind of feeling a little bit emotionally invalidated or bored with the connection. And for others of you Capricorns, I feel like this person that's going to be writing to you or wanting to talk to you or giving you conversation or whatever the case may be, this is going to spark something within you. I feel like this person really gets you crazy. I really feel that way. And with this Page of Wands, you have attractiveness to them as well. That's why this person gets you crazy. And for others of you Capricorns, you are finally sparking the spark with this person that you have been dating. And I feel like you've been wanting to do that for quite some time and things just haven't been happening. I feel like this person, I feel like they've been contemplating on it. And then they're finally ready with this Eight of Wands. So I definitely feel like there's going to be more closeness with this new person, or more closeness in the relationship you're in, more closeness, more touching, more whatever the case may be. And Capricorn, if not, you got somebody who's coming back into your energy and they make you go wild, I feel like. I really do. I feel like it's very hard for you to stay away from this person. I feel like they cause you a lot of challenge inside. They cause you a lot of insecurity, but they may cause you a lot of challenge and insecurity as well when they're not around. I feel like this person just causes you all types of craziness. So we do have the Wheel of Fortune in the mutual energy. So once this passion is happening, once this spark is lit or re-sparked between the two of you, things are going to change. So let's clarify and see how they change, Capricorn, and then we'll get a Moonology card for you. Clarify Capricorn's energy, the mutual energy, and this person that Capricorn is dealing with. We have the Two of Cups. Yes, Capricorn. You're feeling so restricted from this. A lot of you Capricorns, you've been dating somebody or you've been in a relationship and you really want to get things moving. You really want to get closer to this person, but I feel like you don't want to be the first one to make the first move. Wheel of Fortune, the Chariot, Justice with the Three of Wands. Yep, this person is ready. This person is ready to take the lead. This person is ready to get things moving. I feel like a lot of you Capricorns were waiting on this person. Maybe even waiting on this person was driving you crazy at the same time. When they come back, it drives you crazy because of the passion between the two of you or the love you have for them. But we do have the Chariot, so you two are going to be moving forward and leaving this energy here of conflict, boredom, and waiting. So there's going to be a change and there's going to be movement forward. Chariot, Cancer energy. You could live at a distance from this person as well. Maybe traveling to see them. That may be what's happening here. But this person is ready now. They weren't ready before. They were waiting. They were seeing if they were ready for you, Capricorn. But they're ready now with the Three of Wands. I feel like this person may take the lead. Maybe you did try to take the lead and maybe you were rejected. Who knows? But let's get a Moonology for Capricorn. It looks good, Capricorn. I feel like you got to get out of your head. You're not really restricted by this connection. You only feel like you are. But, you know your story. So there may have been a couple things that happened on the end of your end and their end that made you cause this restriction. So let's get a Moonology for Capricorn, and we're closing out the weekend readings. But nice way to close it out, Capricorn. Someone's going to make a move. someone's finally making a move as well. But this new, I feel like this is a lot of you. This is a new person that you've been dating, and you two are just both scared to get close to each other, and you're finally going to get closer. You're finally going to make a move. They're finally going to make a move. Some move is made, and there is victory and movement forward into the future of this connection. So for my Sagittarius, oh, why did I say Sagittarius? For my Capricorns, sorry, you may be dealing with one. For my Capricorn, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. These weekend readings, my mind gets so jumbled because I go from one sign to another sign very fast. Here we go. But Sagittarius was done a while ago, so that was just a sign for some of you. And we have Believe in the Impossible. Capricorn, someone else got this card, and this card doesn't not come out. Blue Moon. Who got this card? I don't want to say the wrong sign. I think it was Leo. So maybe dealing with a Leo. But Believe in the Impossible, or somebody with Leo in their chart. Maybe you got Leo in your chart, but Blue Moon. I do feel that way. Like, I feel like some of you Capricorns, like I said, this person drives you crazy. And maybe you never thought that they would want to be in your energy again. Or maybe you never thought that they would open up to you and want to be closer to you. And here they come. They want this, Capricorn. Maybe you never even thought that they would have taken the lead on it. And they will. Two of Cups as well. Soulmate energy. So Capricorn, Believe in the Impossible. This connection could be something. This connection is going to re-spark, or this connection is going to spark. Don't worry. I feel like a lot of you Capricorns, you've been dating somebody or something's been happening in your love life. Maybe you've been actually in a long-term connection and the spark was just lost. Believe in the Impossible, because it could be re-sparked and it will be re-sparked. And for others of you Capricorns, this is like giving me the vibes of like, being scared to go to first base, scared to go to second base. Like, this person may be scared to hold your hand, or you're scared to hold their hand or kiss them or whatever. But don't worry, because once the floodgates are opened, they're opened. And you are about to get way closer to this person. So Capricorn, thank you for being here. Thank you for watching. And I'll see y'all very, very soon. Go check out your November love readings in the November 2020 playlist. I have dailies going out next week, and the first manifestation video series will be going out next week as well. And Scorpio's bonus reading for their birthday. So, we'll also be going out next week. So, thank you for being here. Thank you for watching. I'll see y'all for the dailies and the manifestation video. Definitely go check that out. The series will start next week. Ring that bell so you're on top of my releases. And I'll see y'all very, very soon. Bye now.